This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft text tools. This video will demonstrate the text tools on the text mask and text prefix suffix panels of the SD text ribbon. The first command is the text arctext attribute mask command with a command alias AM. Select the command and you will notice that it has a couple options. Mask type, which can either be wipeout object are a solid. If you pick solid, you have to specify a color. And if you pick wipeout, you can say you want the frame to be left alone or the frame turned on or frame turned off. An offset factor compared to the text height are the other options that can be set. The difference between this masking and the masking that is part of the Express tools is that this one honors SmartDraft ArcText and dimensions. So if we just select with the window, you'll see the arc text was masked, the MTEXT masking was turned on, the masking for dimension was turned on, and even for these text objects. The next command is the text arc text attribute unmask. AU is the command alias. It will unmask text masked by the SmartDraft text mask command. Select it and you'll notice that everything is unmasked. Now we'll move over to the text prefix suffix. The first command on this panel is the add prefix and or suffix. TFF is the command alias. We can hit O for options and see the various options. We can add a prefix, and in this case we're going to put the word lot in front of those lot numbers, and I want a space between the prefix and what I select, and I'm going to have no suffix. And I'm going to turn off numbers only, which I'm going to explain later. So here I can select these five numbers, hit enter, and you'll see that it added the prefix. If I would have had a suffix, it would have added the suffix easily as well. The next command is the remove prefix and suffix, and I will show you that after I show the preset suffixes and prefixes below this. Next is underline text or mtext. So you can select an mtext object or a text object, and it'll add the underline characters to them. Let's undo those. I can do the same with adding an overscore. Next, there's some preset prefixes and suffixes. Adding parentheses around a piece of text. Adding double parentheses around a piece of text. Adding square brackets, double square brackets, the greater than or the less than symbol, double greater than or less than symbol, the curly braces, double curly braces. In civil engineering, we're very accustomed to using single and double parentheses to indicate an existing value. So let's go up here and use the add prefix command again, this time going into options. And we're going to add EG to two pieces of elevation down there for existing ground. So here we have these two pieces of elevations, and we're just adding existing ground to them. I'm going to remove this line that was used earlier to demonstrate masking. Now if I want to put parentheses around them, there's two options. We can use the numbers only, which will add these prefixes and suffixes around the number and ignore, in this case, the EG. In this case, if we say numbers only, it would do that, having that checked. If it's unchecked, it just puts the prefix at the very beginning of the text string and puts the suffix at the end. So in this case, let's say numbers only. Select these two, and you'll see that it just surrounded the numbers. Even if it was something as complex as an mtext, it just put the prefix and suffix around the number because we said numbers only. Same when it came SmartDraft ArcText. But if we said, had this numbers only unchecked and selected these other elevations, it would actually put the suffix and prefix around the whole string of text instead of looking for the numbers inside. So it depends on how you want to do it when you're adding the prefix or suffix. As I said, I was going to talk about removing suffixes and prefixes. So we'll start this command, and the command alias is up. Look at the options. This command is not what you would call super intelligent, but it does remove an opening and closing parentheses if checked, opening and closing square brackets, opening and closing less than or greater than, opening and closing curly braces. And if we were using the SmartDraft labeling tools, it would remove them from those special type of text without damaging the bearings and distances and radiuses that may be associated with those labels. So here, if I just select with the window, it goes through all of those various text strings, finds the things that we said we wanted to get rid of, and removes them. If you wanted to be a little more fancy and remove the word lot from each one of those, we would have to go back to the edit text properties, select our text, and in this case, type the word lot with a space and hit enter, and it would then remove those word lot in front with a find and replace instead of just remove suffix and prefixes, which is very narrow in focus. This will conclude the demonstration of the SmartDraft text tools on the text mask and text prefix suffix panels. Thank you.